Welcome to Motocraft here on Urban TV, and your presenter is Richard Chiyimba. And in today's program, we have, of course, two segments. The first one is the mechanical segment, and the second one, we are going to be dealing with safety issues. On the mechanical segment, we are still looking at the causes of loss of power in a motor vehicle. Remember that loss of power in a motor vehicle is one of the common problems that drivers face. And it's not just caused by just little issues. There are as many causes as possible as we try to look at them in this show, especially on the mechanical segment show. In today's mechanical segment, we are looking at the fuel filter as part of the cause of loss of power in the motor vehicle. Stay tuned. Dealing with today, we are dealing with a secondary filter of the fuel system, apart from the primary filter which is found in the tank. The secondary filter is within the pipeline, and it's between the engine and also the tank, and that one does the final filtration of the fuel and allows it to be injected into the cylinder. And the unit we are dealing with is this unit. Of course, depending from car to car, this is a Toyota Hiace, and these units are incorporated within the driver and co-driver passenger area, because this kind of vehicle, the engine is placed in the driver's hood, unlike the other versions of station wagons and saloon where the engine is separate. Here the driver sits on top of the engine, and so for me to be able to access this point, I needed to undo the seats. However, looking at the fuel filter, and this unit here is what we call the fuel filter. And the fuel filter is manufactured in such a way that it is detachable. It's not a part that has to live on the car forever. It is a part that has to be changed time and again, and depending on the intervals of service that the car owner and also the environment would allow. Why do I say the environment would allow? Because most environments are very different. For example, if you're driving this car in Europe, all in Japan, all in Dubai, where you have less wind in terms of dust, you have less dust in the environment, then this fuel filter would do a bit more mileage than what it can do now when you're driving in areas in Kampala and also suburbs, as well as upcountry, where you have a lot of dust in the environment. Of course, somehow the dust will find itself into the fuel system, and as the fuel moves into the engine for injection, the dust and the dirt particles will be deposited into the fuel filter. And once they are deposited in the fuel filter, with time they clog so much that they hamper and interfere with the velocity and also the volume of the fuel, which is supposed to be pulled by the fuel pump into the engine. And once this happens, you are going to have the engine register very low fuel pressure. And this one can also trigger the malfunction indicator lamp on the dashboard to come on, that engine check light to say that the vehicle has got a problem, and then the problem is coming from the fuel filter. So the fuel filter retains all those small particles that are in the fuel, and then allows clean fuel to get into the engine. Of course, the fuel filter has got two tubes. One is the inlet tube, another one is the outlet tube. Of course, the inlet is coming from the tank, and the outlet tube is the one which is supposed to be connected to the engine. So when the fuel flows from the tank, it flows into the filter, deposits in the residues like the small chippings and also dust particles, and then clean fuel is allowed to flow out of the filter into the injection system on the injector pump, all on the main injection system if it is a petrol engine. So the flow of that is, of course, in line with the entire operation of the vehicle. So with the time, once these dust particles and small iron chippings and water are clogged into the oil, clog into the fuel filter, then they are going to affect the discharge of the fuel into the engine. And when it comes to areas where you need speed and power, by pressing the accelerator, you are going to find that the response of the engine will be will not synchronize with the action that is put on the accelerator pedal, and so the engine will register low power. Low power because there is a restriction in the fuel pipeline. The fuel that's supposed to be increased to go into the injection system is cut off by, you know, the sediments and also the small particles of dust that are retained into the fuel filter. So, if you're a car owner and you're not adding that, you know, inspecting and also making sure that your fuel, you know, filter has been changed during service, then you stand the chance of, you know, having your fuel system fail, and then the engine will register a lack of power, and then that one will cause you to think that's a very big, you know, cause of the problem, and yet it is as small as changing the fuel filter. So it's very important that when you are doing car service, when you take your vehicle for car service, that you change the fuel filter at the interval that is recommended for the region and also for the environment. If you don't do that, then you stand the chance of having your engine fail because of your fuel filter. Once the engine registers very low turn up of fuel and yet you know the fuel filter is clogged, then it's going to reflect in the kind of power that the vehicle will be producing, especially when it comes to the need for speed and also for hill climbing. So here, in most cases, in Uganda, is most of our filters here will take about, you know, 8,000 kilometers to, you know, 15,000 kilometers, of course, depending on who does your service and where you operate from. But at least every 8,000 kilometers, you should have the fuel filter changed. I know to some people this does not make a lot of sense. Some people do change the filters the way they feel. Somebody just wakes up and says, I think this time I will change the fuel filter, just maybe because of the cost. But I want to tell you that you save much more money if you change your fuel filter on time than waiting for your car to malfunction, because it will malfunction in a way that you may think that it's a very big issue and problem, and yet it's just a need for fuel filter. So fuel filter plays a very important role to make sure that the engine's power is produced as it must be produced. Secondly, when you're looking at the engine, you know, fuel filter, it's very important for you to analyze the way it operates. The other issue about this is, you know, sometimes when you have air bubbles that are trapped within the fuel filter, then you are going to have those air bubbles taken to the injection system, and then they will register a misfiring of the engine, because the engine at a certain stage, instead of pumping in a fuel, it pumps in the air bubbles. So it's very important to eliminate the air bubbles in the fuel pipeline by doing what we call bleeding. Well, in most diesel fuel filters on most of the engines have got what we call a fuel pump hand primer. When you look at this unit here, is what we call a fuel hand primer, and this one helps you in making sure that your fuel filter is full of fuel. For example, if you have just changed your fuel filter, you pump this, you press it, and then it will suck the fuel from the tank and fill the filter, and then it will saturate it to the injection pump. This is what we call a fuel pump hand primer. It is usable. Or secondly, if you have run out of fuel, you are driving and you have run out of fuel, and you need to start your car easily and quickly, after putting the fuel in the tank, you will come and press this a number of times until you feel it is hard. Then it will have to deliver fuel onto the injection system where it will begin to be injected into the engine. So the fuel filter, depending from car to car, there are some vehicles that have the fuel filter, especially for petrol engines. Some of the petrol engines, the fuel filters are located inside the tank. There is a tank assembly which has got a fuel pump, at the same time has the fuel filter. Others, filters are located along the pipelines. They have a metallic kind of a fuel filter that is a bit hard and robust, and it can last a bit longer. But the whole concept of the fuel filter is that once the fuel filter is clogged, then you are going to have to register a loss of power in your motor vehicle. So not every loss of power is caused by bigger factors. Some factors as small as the fuel filter can cause a loss of power.